There's one, a local man has made something special behind us here. A little bit of step back in time, is that right?
Yeah, this a neighbour of mine and a cousin, Michael O'Sullivan, some years ago decided to create this lovely little community space. And I saw during the lockdown a lot of bikers used to stop off here and congregate. It became a lovely congregation point, but it's a lovely little building here, and I suppose it's an example of a house that would have existed many years ago. Tiny little dwelling. I can just lead you up to it here, Michael, if you want to.
Open to the public, your home.
Yeah, it's open to the public. It even has a visitor's book.
Brilliant.
And as I say, it's a very modern recreation of an old house that maybe existed to owned by a local labourer or maybe a local man who maybe lived here just at the end of a lane on a crossroads. Who knows? There would have been a house here at one stage. There's the old Belfast sink.
The side outside.
Yeah. So if you want to have a look in here. So Michael O'Sullivan created this. Now, as I say, it's probably no more than, I don't know, maybe it's 20 years old or thereabouts. But actually, it's a fantastic creation, and you can see all the lovely stonework and memorabilia. Yeah.
He's got a tobacco cutter, I can see. My eyes are peeling and looking at stuff here.
Oh, yeah, it's quite a lot here. Very interesting.
And he's got a little bedroom and all, I see.
Little bedroom here, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and as I say, it's a lovely little space that people often stop off at and come in here, you know. A very positive thing, and I mean, obviously, it was a lot of effort.
Yeah.
And expense on Michael's behalf to create this. So.
A little pram here beside me as well, I can see.
Yeah, quite a lot of little features, as I say. And
this is in the townsland of...
This is in the townsland of Palace, or on Follish, which would have been a palisaded enclosure, would have been in probably in Norman times, a palisade.
And what, before you go, I just read the room. There was a field up the road here, wasn't it, called the Cross Field, is that right? Or the Cross
Oh
field?
Yes, the Cross is, I guess if you were heading this way in the direction of Ballyfad or Kilniner, if you go up what we call the Moat Hill, and there's a moat or a motte on the right hand side as you go up. I remember a friend of mine, Thomas Woodburn, telling me that one of the fields nearby there is called the Crosses. No one's probably sure exactly why it was called, but I guess people stopped maybe there to pray. There may have been crosses there, but yeah, there's a lot of interesting. If you go a little bit closer to us here, just a little bit further up the road here, right on the V where one road leads to Ballyfad, the other leads to Kyle Nairn, the little triangle shape in the middle is known as the Priest's Field. We used to hear that growing up. And the reason it was called the Priest's Field, I believe, was it was technically the centre of the parish of Kyle Nairn. Parish of Kyle Nairn is a massive parish. It has a huge number of townslands, and Anna would be one of them. And across here, it's one of the biggest townslands in Ireland, or maybe the second biggest, and it's divided into seven separate sections, like Anna Long, Anna Middle, Anna Moore, etc. But anyway, to cut long story short, apparently the that would have been the centre of the parish, so technically it would have been where the church should have been, but it's situated in Kyle Nairn now, and we were told at the time because it was close to the Esmond estate, which would be in Ballinastraw. And of course there's close connections between the church in Kyle Nairn and the church in Gorey. So,
and there's one famous thing, I'll leave you with this, and we've got a connection home because we've got a pet lamb at home and her name is Eileen.
Okay.
And is there a famous Eileen connection to here?
There is Eileen O'Roon, of course. Bun Clody like to claim her, and they have made a huge festival around her. But actually, this is the site of Eileen O'Roon and Carúl O'Dálaigh. That's one for another wet day. But basically, the famous love song's been recorded even by Bob Dylan, Eileen O'Roon. Better off not listening to that recording. Now, there's far more melodic recordings in North Wexford here. But the person that wrote the song was none other than Carúl Óg O'Dálaigh, who was part of the famous O'Dálaigh family, and them along with the Muckuckies made up a bardic school which existed here in Palace between the period 1560 and 1630, and they were the professional poets for the O'Byrnes of Wicklow, the O'Byrne clan, and their works can be found in a book called An Leabhar Branach. And as I say, we were told growing up that the Bardic school and where the O'Dowleys were from was probably just across the ditch here, up what would be present day maybe Dixon's. If you go up that lane, it's literally only a stone's throw from here. That's actually the site of the Bardic school, so it would have been one of the great Bardic schools of ancient Ireland. And Carúl O'Dowley, the late president in the 1970s, who would have been president, when he came to, I think he spoke in Inch Hall in the 1960s, and he would have referred to his ancestors coming from this area. So as I say, the O'Dowleys and the McCaughey's, there's a huge amount of beautiful manuscripts associated with them. There's several poets from that clan would have been circled around this area. Some of them were from Anna Moore, others were from Rat Pierce, but quite the most of them would have been here in Pallas, so in Follish. So if you can, this was one of the great centres of poetry in ancient Ireland between 1560 and 1630. Da 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 da